Professor Dave here. Let's check out Power Series.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We've seen a few different types of series up until this point, so let's check out another. A power series is one that takes the form C sub n times x to the n power, from 0 to infinity. So we get C0 first, with no x, because x to the 0 is 1. Then the next term is C1 times x. Then C2 times x squared, and so forth. The C's are constants that we call coefficients, and the sum of this series can be represented by a function, f of x, where we just add up all the terms, resulting in what looks like a polynomial with infinitely many terms. The domain of this function is the set of all x values for which this series converges. Now let's look at some specific examples and see what we can determine regarding convergence and divergence. Let's say we take this general form and we make all the coefficients equal to 1. That would give us this geometric series here, which will be convergent when x is in between negative 1 and 1. We may also see power series in this form, where the binomial x minus a is being raised to the n power. How can we assess whether this kind of power series is convergent or divergent? Sometimes we will use the ratio test. Take something like the quantity x minus 3 raised to the n power over n. Remembering the ratio test from the previous tutorial, let's change n into n plus 1, and then take the regular version and flip it to bring it up here. To simplify, x minus 3 raised to the n plus 1 can become x minus 3 raised to the n times x minus 3 raised to the 1. This more complicated term then cancels, leaving us with x minus 3 times n over n plus 1. Now let's divide this fraction by n to get 1 over the quantity 1 plus 1 over n. As these are all positive, we can pull them out of the absolute value brackets, leaving just x minus 3 in there. Now, bringing n up to infinity, this whole part just becomes 1, leaving us with the absolute value of x minus 3. In order to be convergent, this has to be less than 1. So given the absolute value, we know that x minus 3 must be less than 1 and greater than negative 1. Adding 3 throughout, we get x as being between 2 and 4. So those are the values for which the series converges. In general, there is a theorem that summarizes the three possibilities that can describe a power series in this form, depending on the precise series. One possibility is that the series converges when x equals a. A second possibility is that the series converges for any value of x. And lastly, there could be some positive number r, such that if the absolute value of x minus a is less than r, the series will converge, and if greater than r, the series will diverge, just like the example we just completed. In this third case, that number r is called the radius of convergence for that power series. The first two cases also involve a radius of convergence. It is simply that for the first case, the radius of convergence is 0, as there is only one value that will allow for convergence. And for the second case, the radius of convergence is infinite, as any value will allow for convergence. We can also describe the interval of convergence as the interval describing all the values of x for which the series converges. Let's try an example and see how this applies. Take x to the n over n factorial. What can we do with this? Let's try the ratio test. We get x to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial, and then, given the original series in the denominator, we just multiply by the reciprocal, or n factorial, over x to the n. We've simplified something like this a couple times by now, so let's change n plus 1 factorial into n plus 1 times n factorial. And let's change x to the n plus 1 into x to the n times x to the 1. Most of this cancels out, and we are left with x over n plus 1. Finding the limit as n approaches infinity, we see that we will get 0 no matter what the value for x. This means that the radius of convergence is infinity, and the interval of convergence is negative infinity to positive infinity. This fits the second possibility from that theorem, which tells us that this series is always convergent. That covers the basics regarding power series, so let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.